a very pleasant good morning to all of you. This is Shabana Parveen, your computer teacher. I welcome you all in standard 11 in 2K20 batch in this institution, Kerala School. Dear students, you are fortunate enough to be a part of Kerala family. Now, there is no doubt that you will not excel in academics, but at the same time in rest of the fields wherever you want to make your dreams come true. So students, cooperate with the teacher, cooperate with your classmates, and of course cooperate with yourself by watching the videos on regular basis, either through the Campus Care app or through the YouTube directly. But your attendance will mark when you will go through the videos by the help of Campus Care. There is an app, Campus Care, where you will get the video link of the subject teachers. And there is a provision in sending the messages too. So students, whenever you feel any doubt, you can message through the Campus Care app or through the WhatsApp group. So first of all, I want to highlight the importance of the subject computer in every fields. Whether the field is countless where you can see the uses of computers. So it is an intelligent decision that you have opted computer as a subject in standard 11, and you will get benefited by this subject in your higher studies. One thing I want to bring into your notice is that we teachers do not have any other platforms except Campus Care and WhatsApp group to get connected with you all. Therefore, it is my request that you make your ID with your real name, the name which you have enrolled yourself in the school, as well as your own photographs, so that the teachers can post or share the messages whenever they require comfortably. Now, I want to give you a brief introduction of the subject IP. The IP syllabus is consist of 4 units. Unit 1 contains the introduction of computer system. Unit 2 contains the introduction to Python programming language. Unit 3 is the database concept and structured query language. In short, it is SQL. And last, unit 4 is the introduction of emerging tools. So I will tell you in details in upcoming videos. So stay tuned for the upcoming videos. Let us see the syllabus of informatic practices in details. The syllabus is divided into 4 units. The first unit which I had taught was the introduction to computer system. From this unit, 10 marks question will be asked. Unit 2 is the introduction of Python program, which is of 25 marks. Unit 3 is database concept and structured query language. And the question asked from this very unit is 30. And the last unit, which is unit 4, is introduction to emerging trends, which is of 5 marks. So altogether, unit 1 to unit 4 contains 70 marks. This 70 marks is the theoretical marks or the theory marks. Next, we will see the practical one. So the practical syllabus
is categorized into again four categories. On the day of board practical exam, you will get the question of Python, which is of 11 marks. And you will have the question related to the topic database and SQL, which is of 7 marks. So this 11 and 7 is the marks which will come on the day of the practical exam. Third one, where you need to make the practical file, in that very file you will write 14 Python programs and 14 SQL queries, which is of 7 marks. And the last one, Viva Voce, which is of 5 marks. So this practical comprises of 30 marks. So altogether, theory as well as practicals comes as 100 marks. Now we will move with unit 2. So we will start with unit 2, not with unit 1, because more weightage on unit 2 as well as unit 3. So we will start with unit 2. Afterwards, we will see the unit 3 and then unit 1 and 2 at last. So first we will begin with unit 2, which is introduction to Python. So first of all, you should know what Python is. So Python is not a reptile, not a snake, which you were knowing. Actually, here in the world of computer, Python is a programming language. Which type of language it is? It is easy to learn, powerful object programming language. It is high level programming language like C, C++, Java, etc. That means through the Python language, we will create the program, we will develop the program, and that program will be the object oriented programming language. And like other high level language programming language, this Python is also a high level language program. Python language was developed by Guido van Rossum in February 1991. These all things you need to note down along with the syllabus in your classwork copy. Okay, so Python language was developed by whom? It was developed by Guido van Rossum. In which year? In 1991. Now we will see next topic of Python, which is the very important topic regarding the Python. Advantage, pluses or strengths of Python. Means what are the different advantages or the strengths of the Python language. So the first advantage is it is easy to use language. Easy to use. When you will see how it is easy to use, then the topic which is explained here is Python is compact and very easy to use object oriented language. It is easy to use object oriented language with simple syntax. Syntax means the grammatical rules. Every programming language must have to follow its rules, its grammatical rules. This grammatical rules is known as the syntax of the language. So Python language syntax is very simple. It is very high level language and thus very very programmer friendly. It means the syntax is very simple, so the user can easily understand the program. And writing the program is also very easy because of its simple syntax. Syntax means the grammatical rules. Next advantage of Python is it is easy to read language. Easy to read language means Python's code is just like simple English language. much more clearly defined. That means when you will write the Python program, it is like that you are writing English type of language. As English language is easily understood by us, therefore when you will write the Python program, it is also easily readable as well as it is clearly defined. So it is easy to use, easy to read. Third advantage, third pluses or third strength is it is an interpreted language. Interpreted language means that Python is an interpreted based language. When you, if you have any idea regarding any of the programming language, then you must know about the interpreted based language. The languages are two types, whether it is C, C++, Java, Python, Fortran, COBOL, any type of languages are of two types. One type is interpreter based language and another type is compiler based language. So Python is which type of language? Python is interpreted based language. It is not a compiler based language. Then which language is compiler based language? The C language is compiler based language. C++ is compiler based language. But Python, Java, etc. are interpreted based language. What does interpreter based language means? Interpreter based language means that Python language executes the code. Code means the script, the program lines, the statement. So the code will execute line by line at a time. That means when you will write the program, that programs will be executed line by line at a time. One line will execute, then it will move to the next line and so on. But it is not in the case of compiler based language. It is interpreter based language because the program executes line by line. And in Python also, the Python language executes the program, executes the code line by line at a time. And it makes easy to debug language. When any of the programming language executes its code line by line, then it is easy to debug. Easy to debug. Here the term debug means removal of error. When you will write the program and if any error comes, then that errors can be easily rectified. Because each line, if any error, will show the error there at the moment where the error comes. So the easy to debug is possible in Python because the program executes line by line and thus suitable for beginners to advanced user. So whether it is a beginner or the advanced user, for both of them it is easy to debug the language as well as it is suitable for both the users, whether they are the beginner one or they are the advanced users. So these advantages, or you can say the plus or the strengths of Python, which you have to note down in your copy. In the next class we will see rest of the advantages of Python along with the disadvantages of Python. Till then I want to say you thank you, and in the next video we will come with the new topic of Python.